I'm with you in a moment.
Don't walk away.
Doctor, I can't feel my arm.
Just a minute.
I can't feel it. Doctor, I can't feel my arm.
Ray, I can't feel your arm right now either. Can somebody feel his arm?
I can't feel it.
Don't touch my hair.
Kiss the boo-boo. Kiss the boo-boo.
Hey, you're still here.
Yeah, I'm still here. Can you believe it? Oh, hey, send me some coffee, you savage.
Down here. And it's over here, and it's on my hands, going up my arm.
This guy presents. Let's go. Here, what's the problem?
Gunshot wound, shoulder and abdomen. We've been paging you for 5 minutes. You on California time already?
I have some radiology working on my tan.
Plus 120.
Okay, get this guy typed and crossed, huh? Okay, question. Beverly Hills, the most beautiful woman in the world, plastic surgery. What do these three things have in common? Huh? Me, in less than a week. Okay, don't worry about his shoulder. This guy's probably bleeding internally. Lap him, push another bottle of Rainers. Call Dr. Stott and tell him to prep for OR, because I'm out of here tonight. Man, try and convince me I'm going to be nostalgic for this place, and I'm at the Halberstam Clinic.
You going to Halberstam?
Cosmetic surgery for the rich and famous.
Yeah, well, I'm not in it for the money.
$500,000 salary the first year he makes partner.
But the high-profile, high-profit stuff just makes it possible for us to do reconstructive surgery for the
needier patients. You're a saint. Get another customer over there.
All right, get out of here. I'll cover it. My going away present to you. Okay, what's the problem?
Too much fun. Substance unknown.
Okay, stay with us. Hey, stay with us. What'd you take, man, huh? Bluebirds, Dillies, Love Boats?
I heard Halberstam might not even hire anyone this year.
Well, I'm not anyone. Listen, Mulready, some of the guys are having a little bash for me tonight. Going away party, you know? And if you're interested in it, I'd love
not
to.
Not in this line, John.
Clean up.
Thanks. Well, what do you say, nice guys? Dinner, huh?
Sorry, Ben.
Think about it. Come on, it's my last night. A couple of lousy beers. Guys. Send you a postcard. What?
At the risk of sounding schmaltz here, I just want to tell you that you're a schmuck and I hope I never see you again.
Thanks, Tommy. I know how hard it was for you to say that.
Well, you're a good doctor, Ben. I just thought you were going to practice real medicine.
You think I'm making a mistake on a Halberstam?
Nah. Cosmetic surgery, it's clean. You make tons of money. Nobody dies. What's wrong with that, right?
Right.
Bye, Ben.
That way, it's the end of it. Where am I now? Okay. Shit. Accident. Woman in the middle of the road with a cow! Oh, God. Oh, all right. I'm okay. Oh, man, my car. Oh, man, I'm front end is shot! Well, glad you're here.
Is that a 56 or 57, Speedster?
56. Hey, come on, get out, get out. Will you get out of the car? Get away from there!
Took me 3 weeks to build that fence.
Look, I'm sorry.
Now, does this have a Super 90 engine or a 1600?
The way I look at it, it wasn't really anybody's fault. So my insurance company will probably pay for the entire fence, and that should be fine. Is it okay?
Won't be the same.
Wait, this ain't a kit car.
No, it ain't. It isn't. My name is Ben Stone. Look, I'm a doctor. I'm a medical doctor. I'm a surgeon.
Hey!
Awesome. Who thrashed the fence?
I'm Ben Stone. Now, I can give you the address of my clinic in Los Angeles.
Did he just say he's Ben Stone?
He says he's from L.A.
Send me a bill there. If you want, we can handle it with plastic. I'm not really from L.A. I'm just on my way to...
You lucky. I just happen to be passing through.
What's in the trunk? Pot?
Oh. I'm a surgeon. Come on. Will you get away? Get away! Get away from the car.
Sorry.
Not you, the... dog.
Probably the finest fence I'll ever put up.
Sir. I know Willie Stone up in Stanton. The family of yours.
Can I tell you, I understand what you're trying to do.
Hey, this the new Mazda?
What's your speed? Put up with any small town bullshit.
Hey, where's the dang engine?
Whoa! Get away from this car. You're not touching this car. You don't even know where the engine is.
Gotcha.
Look, I'm sorry about what happened, but it was an accident, okay? It was nobody's fault. Get me to a telephone. I'll call a Porsche mechanic in the next big city. I'll get my car fixed. I'll be on my way, and you can go back to doing, you know, whatever it is you do. Huh? All right, I admit it. I flattened a damn fence. What are you going to do, lock me up?
Court finds defendant guilty of crimes under Motor Vehicle Code 453-19, reckless driving, and 466-2, reckless endangerment.
This is insane.
No, this is great.
Your Honor, there were cows in the middle of the road. Now, I told you my insurance company would be happy to pay for a new fence.
I built that fence myself. Neither you nor your insurance can pay me for a fence I built myself. Can't be done. Next best thing would be a fence that you built.
These hands are delicate instruments.
I doubt you could build a good fence anyway. Therefore, seeing as how you're a licensed physician, and we are a town in acute shortage of medical care...
Oh, you would.
Your sentence will be 16 hours of community service served as resident doctor at Grady Memorial Hospital.
All right, look, I have to be in Los Angeles by Tuesday, so I don't...
32 hours.
This is extortion!
You want 64 hours?
No.
Order's adjourned.
All right!
I am so fucked.
Watch your language, Doc. You're in the buckle of the Bible Belt here. Might try saying fudge or something.
Fiddlesticks too strong?
Depends.
Now, don't you worry about your automobile now, Doc. See, I always wanted an excuse to buy me a set of metric tools.
Sugar. Fuck! I'm Dr. Benjamin Stump. Nurse Packer. I'm assuming Judge Evans called you. Fine, here's what I need. Comfortable bed, hot shower, warm meal, locker to put my stuff in, general idea.
Could you show me some kind of identification, please?
Wearing glasses, Era. Wear contacts now. My hair's a little shorter. That's a mustache. It's a bad picture. If you could just direct me to the physician on call tonight, I'll speak to him.
When to call me? You've been stabbed, shot, poisoned, separated from an appendage, knocked or beaten unconscious, run over by a tractor mower, or generally about to bleed to death. Otherwise, leave me alone. Signed, Dr. Aurelius Edson Holm, M.D.
I'm in the Twilight Zone.
To be back in vitamin C in the upper cabinet if you're hungry.
Wait a minute. This is the best you can do?
No.
Oh, good. You're awake. Welcome to Grady. I'm Mayor Nicholson. Boy, second I heard there's a big city doctor here in town, I left that rehearsal. I hightailed over here like an eight-legged dog. See if there's anything I can do to make you more comfortable. Shoot, we can do better than this.
No, better than this.
Say, these your duffels? I'm not claiming the Grady's no Paris, France, or nothing, but we do got two gas stations. Got us a Winn-Dixie, got us cable TV. You like to play tennis? We got a brand new tennis court over to the high school. No, you doctors play golf, though, don't you, Hall?
Learn how to surf, actually.
Miss Purdy, we had this fixed up with a doctor, and we got through the one ads a couple years ago. Nobody's been in it for a while, though.
Mayor Nicholson?
Yeah?
I'm on my way to California. Don't be thinking I'm going to be staying here.
Oh, no, no, of course not. Well, maybe not. Then you give old Grady a chance. She just might sneak up on you and be in the bottle.
Welcoming committee.
I hope you're hungry.
Evening, ladies. Oh. Ben Stone, this here is Miss Violet and Miss Lillian and Miss Maddie. Ladies, this here is Ben Stone, M.D.
Fried chicken, boiled peanuts, and sweet potato pie.
Catfish, biscuit, butter beans, and watermelon.
Hungry man dinner. I'm a bad cook.
Well, I guess I'll just say adieu and come show for you in the morning.
No, wait, come on. Dick, you're just not gonna leave me here in the middle of nowhere with them. It's getting late.
Oh, don't worry. Only one of them horny. I'm not telling you which one. No.
You face.
Want a cocktail?
So anyway, the high profile, high profit work just makes it possible for me to do the more important reconstructive surgery for a needier patient. And get a big house on the beach.
It's just hard to believe. A man as good looking as Dr. Stone should be married.
Well, maybe he ain't found his Adam rib yet, by.
Maybe he indulges in the love that dare not speak its name.
Lillian.
Will I go blind? It's moonshine, right?
Well, ouzo, actually.
We took a cruise to Greece.
Not me. I wasn't invited.
It was one of those golden agers tours.
Sunset tour, by honey.
They ate the brains out of a goat.
Not me.
We ate dogs.
I don't eat no dog.
You don't know that you didn't. Now, Dr. Stone, there's a legend about friendship quilts.
That's bunk.
Folks say that the first person to sleep under a friendship quilt will meet the one they're gonna marry.
Dream about the one they're gonna marry, and it's bunk.
What a fine hand he has. Dr. Stone. Dr. Stone. Dr. Stone.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi. Good morning.
Is something wrong?
No. I'm a doctor.
Yeah, I know who you are.
Oh, hey, I'm sorry. Do you want this?
If you're a doctor, I don't have anything you haven't seen before. You can blink now.
All the boys from the state legislature come here to do the recreating. Boy, can they litter. Your presidents come here during the fishing season.
On purpose.
Well, looking at all this, Ben Boy, I'm sure you're saying to yourself, I have come to Grady at the most beautiful time of the year. But boy, these dogwoods, azaleas, when they blooming, they can't hold a candle to the nuclear explosion of color come fall.
Look, Nick, you're the mayor. You have the authority to commute my sentence. Could you do that? Look, I'll make it worth your while, all right? I get back to L.A., maybe we can work something out.
Why on earth would I want to do that? How am I going to convince you to stay here if you're not here? We need a doctor. You need patients. Get off the interstate, Ben Stone. Right? Now, don't let the signs of prosperity and urban sprawl here in downtown scare you. We're still the same sleepy little paradise that many big city shrinks recommend for their patients with nervous disorders. It's the common effect of Grady's natural ozone. In fact, there's a world-class mental hospital just up the road with us.
That's a comforting thought.
Ben Stone, you like coffee? If you like coffee, we won't go in here.
Is that him?
That's him.
He's young, huh?
Boys, this here is Ben Stone, the Hollywood physician who's going to be spending a couple few days with us. Ben, this here is Mortimer, John, Aubrey. Probably don't want to shake his hand. Sorty over in the corner there. Sorty got a cow that sings. Of course, you remember Cotton, Miss Lillian?
Hollywood, La La Lane.
Beverly Hills accent.
Whatever. Well, William's been a movie star.
No, oh, Aubrey, it was just an army training film.
Oh, come now, you were the star. You played the leading role.
It was about VD. I was the bacterial. Had a big scene with penicillin.
Yes. A death scene.
Take a load off, Doctor. This'll stop your worries.
We're stardom.
So, Doc, what do you think of our town?
Well, I don't know. I haven't seen all of it yet.
Oh, yeah, you have. Opportunity abounds here.
The growth rate was up 0.3% last year.
There's no crime. By the way, we are the county seat.
Fellas, no point in beating a dead horse to death. That's all in the brochure. Ben Stone, we are prepared to offer you a permanent position as medical practitioner supreme here in the greater Grady metropolitan area and squash capital of the South. And the salary is $27,000 per annum and plus housing.
$27,000?
You see, Nick, I told you. All right, okay. $30,000.
Look, you people don't even know me.
Oh, I noticed right off, Eddie. Double knots of shoelaces.
Oh, excellent credentials.
Shoji's careful.
Anyway, don't you already have a doctor?
Oh, yeah, with that hold. See, the problem with hold,
he's old.
Old and wholly unpleasant.
Point is, he's not going to be around forever.
$35,000? Well, yeah, but that takes a unanimous vote of the whole entire city council. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Unanimous.
I abstain.
You always abstain.
Look, I appreciate your problem, but I'm not the answer. Now, I got a big job interview on the West Coast. It's very important I get there in the next couple of days. Plastic surgery, you know? The truth is, well, they could probably pay me about 20 times what you could afford.
Well, now, you know, there's a lot of similarities between Grady and Los Angeles.
Yeah, they're just bigger is all.
What do I owe you?
$10.
$10 for a cup of coffee and a couple pieces of toast?
Gotcha.
Now, Ben, I tell you, why did you wait to make up your mind till after the squash festival, huh? All I'm saying, Ben Stone, is give Grady a chance. I bet you like her.
Yeah, well, nice meeting you all. Thanks. Well, howdy, Nurse Packer. How you doing?
Doctor's lounge is down the hall. You can change in there, and then I'll have Lou show you around. This is your time card.
You gotta be kidding.
Local call?
I don't know anybody local.
Payphone's in the waiting room.
Yeah, it's a collect call from Dr. Benjamin Stone. Stone. Hey, come on, do you mind? This is a personal call.
I guess so.
Yeah, hi. Yes, this is Dr. Stone. Actually, that's why I'm calling. I don't think I'm gonna be able to make it on Tuesday. No, there was a medical emergency, and they don't have a doctor, so of course I volunteered my services, and I'll need to stay until the situation stabilizes. Yeah, medically speaking. You're interviewing other doctors. Friday. Yeah, okay, Friday, I can do that. Okay, no, thank you very much, and thank Dr.
That was better tap dancing than I've seen on Star Search.
You know, if you tell me you're here for a physical, you're gonna make my day.
It's unprofessional to flirt with the patients.
I'm just on my way to Beverly Hills. Plastic surgery. Not that you need any.
Nice try. So is this a GQ look for young urban doctors?
Well, I've spent the last 2 years doing 18-hour days in the ER. I find these are pretty comfortable. You don't like them?
No.
Okay, fine. Well, I really enjoyed our time together here, but since you're obviously not a patient and I'm not getting anywhere, tell me where I can find a guy named Lou who drives an ambulance. I'll get out of your life.
I'm Lou.
Where did all these people come from?
Folks said there's a doctor on duty at the hospital. They come running. Any old doctor.
Send him in. Okay, Mr. Tidwell. What the hell have you got on your foot?
That's a poultice.
Nurse Packer!
I got a hold to old Doc Hogue on the CB, and he said that that hold me till I had time to come in.
You did this on purpose?
Yes, sir. Chimney soot, biscuit flour, and lard. Doc Hogue said...
Wipe that crap off Mr. Tidwell's foot, please, and clean that wound out. You allergic to penicillin?
Don't know. You'd have to ask Doc Hogue.
Doubt Doc Hogue knows it's even been discovered. Okay. Nurse Packer, I'm going to wash this with Betadine. Close it with a butterfly. Give it a sterile dressing.
Oh, you sure you ought to be doing that so darn fast?
Well, I hope so, Mr. Tidwell. Because je suis fini.
Olé.
Okay, Mrs. Owens, if you could please get up on the table, put your feet in the stirrups.
We're just here about our mail.
It's from my sister. We don't read.
This ever happened to you before, Mr. McClary?
Hell, yes, it happens. Oh, this ain't nearly the biggest one I ever took. I had a hook in my thigh once. It must have been,
fishing's a dangerous business.
Well, it can be.
And after the cow died, there just wasn't any reason for him to go on. Meanwhile, Ellen's got herself mixed up with a Pakistani gentleman who nobody can understand what he is saying. Not even Ellen. You know, I don't see any toxic striations. Red streaks. You sure it was a Black Widow?
Here. I kept it in some TP. Oh, dear Lord. It's escaped.
She thinks Ray's having an affair with the pastor's wife, but Ray swears it's just scrub oak rash. Ray is a nut, I'm telling you.
It's like a blurred spot in my vision. Out there, no. There, no. No, there. I'm cured.
pastor's wife got busted for growing marijuana out behind the rectory. So she'll be spending a spell up in Tupelo at the minimum security prison. Well, that's it. What about Ellen and the Pakistani?
Nurse Packer, where's Doc Ho? The boy can't breathe right, and he's turning blue.
I'm the doctor here.
Nurse Packer, you gotta call Doc Hogue. Please.
It's all right. I'm the doctor. How long's he been like this?
All afternoon.
What's his name?
Zeb.
Hey, Zeb. It's gonna be a little cold, all right? I just want to hear your heart. Did you tell me her? All right. Okay, why don't you take him down to the examination room? I'll be right there. You know where that is? Right there.
All right.
Okay? Can you have Zeb get up on the table for me? All right, call Hogue, get him right away.
He doesn't like to be disturbed after he's
returned. I really don't care. I'll tell you what, forget Hogue. What's the referral hospital?
Athens General.
Call Athens General. Tell him we got a possible cardiac emergency. Call Lou, tell her to fire up the ambulance. No, forget it. They have a helicopter, right? Tell them to send the helicopter. And give me all the medical history you have on this boy.
I think I better call Dr. Hogue.
Damn it! Listen to me. Hogue is not here. I'm here. You do it. Okay, here's the situation. Your son is turning blue because he has an abnormal mitral valve. It's causing a backflow of blood in his heart. We may have to operate him. We'll send him to Athens General as soon as possible.
Dr. Hogue said you should give the boy a Coke.
What?
He says he's probably got a bellyache and that you should give him a Coke.
Listen, doctor, I got a boy here in cardiac crisis. You can't treat that with Coca-Cola or Bisquick. We're going to have to use real medicine this time. Now, I'm sending him to Athens General. You're his regular fucking doctor. You get your fat ass out of bed. Get down here and go with him. How long is it going to take that goddamn chopper to shoot?
Should be here any minute.
Stone.
Dr. Hogue?
What the hell kind of snot-nosed puppy doctor are you anyway? Wake me out of a sound sleep? Scare these poor folks out of their skivvies?
Mitral valve regurge.
Ah.
Look, I've had a lot of experience with it in the ER, okay? I've even assisted in the surgery to correct. Now, God only knows how long he's had this, but I guess you overlooked it. Now, why don't you go and check his color?
Nurse Packer, get that crap off of the boy. Gene? You gave him the bismuth subnitrate, didn't you?
Well, first we thought it was the skitters.
You gave him too much, as usual. Turned him three shades of blue.
Bismuth subnitrate?
Homegrown and acid. You hear a heart murmur?
No, it's hard to detect.
You've been sampling your daddy's chaw. Mm-hmm. That'll be 65 cents. Well, nice work, Hollywood. You were just about to crack open the chest of a six-year-old boy to cure a case of diarrhea. Now listen up, smartass. Next time I tell you how to treat a patient of mine, you better damn well do it, doctor. I doubt you'd know crap from Crisco.
Hey.
Guten Abend, Herr Doktor.
Yeah. Right. Shit!
Wait. Hold your horses, Doc. Now, what would if I walked in the middle of a hernia operation, see some poor gentleman guts all over?
You killed my car.
I resent that.
That car was my life, Melvin. That car was my baby.
You want me to stop now? I could put it in some boxes, ship it out to Hollywood for you. No skin off my nose.
Oil pumping house.
You and me called it an oil pump casing. Lane had 2 years of the German language in high school.
Es ist kaputt.
Doc, let's step into my office.
I don't need a car. I'm moving to Los Angeles. What do I need a car for?
Lash yourself to the mast, Doc. This fella up in Oregon, he's got an oil pump. He could have expressed to us tomorrow. $239 plus shipping. Only one problem.
Oregon exploded.
No. He don't take credit.
Uh-huh.
All checks. And tomorrow being Saturday, you can't just wire some cash to him.
Okay, Melvin. Let me ask you this. How do you propose I pay for this?
Well, I was hoping you'd pay me, then I could trade him for a front rock assembly I got from the 68 Nova, but...
You don't take credit and you don't take checks.
No, sir. I apologize.
How long will this guy in Oregon wait?
Imagine I could stall him to Sunday noon. Now, he got another taker in Arizona, but I was first.
Stall him.
Hi, Doc.
Hi, Doc.
Morning, Doc.
Hey, Doc.
Morning, Ben Stone.
Morning, Doc Stone.
And y'all?
Dr. Stone? Dr. Stone, I presume?
Yeah, that's right.
Hi.
Hi.
Say, you're much taller than they said you were.
I'm sitting on a stool.
Oh.
And then you are?
Dying to get out of this town. How about you?
Here's your breakfast.
Lillian, I haven't ordered yet.
Compliments of the house. Don't let old Hoag scare you off, Doc. We know you weren't aiming to kill that boy last night.
Wait a minute. You're not planning on staying in Grady.
Oh, only as long as I have to.
Thank God. For a second there, I thought they got their hooks into you, too.
But you don't like Grady?
No.
So how come you don't leave?
With you? Is that a proposition, Doctor? Yeah, well,
you asked your great. I could read this before it gets cold. Excuse me. Nice meeting you.
Sure.
Thanks, Lulu. Prosser on torts. Civil procedure. A little light reading this morning, Miss Lou.
Did I invite you to sit down?
No, but you were going to Southern Hospitality and all.
Now what?
Now let's talk about you.
Okay. I like my privacy. I'm a vegetarian, and I'd appreciate it if you take that slab of ham back up to the counter with you. It gives me the willies.
I didn't order this slab.
Oh, let's see. Now I suppose you'll say something cute to stall your retreat. Maybe tell me all about the big city, all the things I'm missing living in this dinky old town, and how you'd like to be the one to take me out of it.
Yeah, okay, now that you mention it, isn't that why you're going to law school? Because you want to get the hell out of this dinky little town?
I'm not going yet. And I plan to practice in Grady when I'm through.
Yeah, it looks like a hotbed of legal activity.
Well, malpractice for visiting young surgeons seems promising.
Who's the green apple, Valula?
Henry, this is Ben Stone.
Hey. Oh, yeah. New croaker. Hank Gordon. You're in my chair.
Boyfriend?
Friend.
Need any life insurance?
What?
You should be vested in a term life program. Probably quarter of a mil to start. Come by my office. We could run a what if. Or are you too chicken?
Dr. Stone, I read somewhere that doctors have the highest suicide rate in any profession except for dentistry. Now, is that true?
I won't underwrite dentists. Nope. Never trust a man who put his hand in your mouth.
Well, I'd love to stay in here where this conversation's headed, but if you'll all excuse me.
There's something else I wanted to ask you. Do doctors know more about sex than normal people?
I need some ketchup.
I have a fair knowledge of animal husbandry. It's all pretty much the same thing.
Bye, Doc. Bye.
Women trouble, Ben Stone?
Nah.
Squatter. Regard the Grady squash, sir.
Looks like a yellow zucchini.
Nope, nope. See, up until 1933, you had your Grady, you had your zucchini. They're going at it, gourd to gourd. Freak tornado accident wiped out a whole entire shipment of Grady's bound for, I personally believe, agricultural stardom at Chicago World's Fair. The zucchini took the never relented. If we're going the other way, no telling where this town would be today.
What are you talking about?
Timing. Same thing with women. And with Southern women, well, they require substantial commitment. You might have to stay here 6 months. I don't know, maybe more.
Are you a betting man, Nick?
Well, I have been known on occasion.
Take me about a week.
No, wait a minute. You mean by Lula in the center pocket?
$10.
Okay, you got it. feels like I'm fleecing you, Ben Stone.
Easy. Ugh. Hello, Mr. Packer. All right. Okay, let's get something straight right now, okay? I got 8 years of higher education. I got 1 year of internship. I got 1 year of residency. I'm $70,000 in debt. Now I'm waylaid in this hee-haw hell, and you insist on clocking me in and out like I'm some kind of factory worker? Well, no! N-O! No! This is where I draw the line.
I believe you have a visitor, Doctor.
Doc, my foot feels so good, I brought you this peg.
Okay.
I can't abide being in no man's debt. This pig's all I got to give.
I'm already paid more or less by the hospital. I really can't accept your pig.
It's a done deal. She's your pig now. God bless you both.
Keep your animal outside. This is a hospital.
Nice pig there, Doc.
Thank you.
Lovely pig, Doc.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Nice pig, Doc.
Thank
you. Nice pig, Doc.
Thank you. Thank you all very much.
Ben Stone! Say, I think I just took away your last reason to go to California.
Mossville Drum and Bugle Corps. They played last 4 years at the Rose Parade. I got them under exclusive contract to the Great
Nick,
Squash Festival.
Nick, I'm not staying.
Sure you are. Oh, by the way, dinner at my house tomorrow night at 6 o'clock.
Dinner?
Yeah. Didn't I tell you? You're a guest of honor. You a monkey. If my head wasn't attached, I'd need wood screws.
Nice pig, Doc.
Thanks. Can I bring a date?
Well, I don't know. Can you?
It's Ben Stone you're talking to. Come on, pig.
Fine, pig, Doc.
Melvin? Melvin? Melvin?
Doc, we're just rehearsing for the pageant. We doing a pollination rap song.
Melvin, listen, I don't have the money for the oil pumpkin housing thing. I mean, when I say I haven't got the money, I mean, that's not entirely true. I mean, I have the money. I'm good for the money. It's just a matter of, you know, accessing the money in a period of time. Can we work something out, please? I mean, his car has got to be ready by the time I leave, you know?
That's your pig.
Yeah. You want to trade the pig for the part?
If you can part with the pig.
Good.
Hi. You just picked those?
Yes, ma'am.
They're protected by law. State flowers.
Figures. Oh, well, I'm already serving time for the fence. I might as well take my chances, right?
Mama? Mama, who is it?
Who are you?
I'm Ben.
I'm gonna take these inside and put them in some water, okay?
You're not supposed to pick these.
Use the plastic pitcher.
Yeah, she's mine. She's four. You want to retreat now, or?
No, I just came by because, I need a date for dinner tomorrow night.
Nick Nicholson's?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Can't poop in this town without everyone knowing what color it is. I was, fixing to have a cocktail. Are you in a hurry?
Oh, man, that's tart.
It's called a slow, comfortable screw up against a wall with a twist.
Is that a Grady specialty?
No. New York City.
New York?
Yeah, I worked at one of those weirdo theme bars on the West Side. Wayne and I went to college in New York.
Wayne.
Then he dropped out. I got pregnant. He couldn't get work, so I bartended. I managed to finish school, though.
Wayne isn't still...
Wayne is a professional dancer. You know, one of those exotic Chippendale things? He's in Boston, Miami. I can't keep track. He left me after Emma was born. I divorced him and came running back here. Wayne has this extremely high opinion of his legs.
You know, I just can't picture you in the big city. In New York. Yeah, it's like me.
And Grady? Well, peel an onion, there's lots of layers.
What layer is Hank on?
Henry Gordon's sweet on me. And he's pretty decent and solid once you get past the insurance rebel without a clause routine.
Decent and solid. Very romantic.
I can see you coming from half a mile away, Dr. Stone. You and your slick city ways. I suspect your version of romance is whatever will separate me from my panties.
What? All I'm talking about is dinner. You know, in public, wear a dress. Panties are optional.
Well, I never have had dinner at the mayor's house.
Oh, boy.
And after all, how could I possibly refuse the man who saved Jasmine from the butcher?
What? What are you talking about?
Tidwell's pig. He was about to take her in and sell her for pork chops. You hadn't fixed his foot and made him feel guilty. Emma loves pigs. You keeping her over at your house?
Lane, where's Milk? Where's Melvin? I want my pig back. Wait, did you say he went to church at this hour? Hey, Lane, are you allowed to come out of here? Because I can't understand what the hell you're saying.
The pig took to the butcher.
Melvin took my pig to the butcher? Where's my pig? You know, Jasmine, my pig is, she's still alive.
Oh, yeah, yeah, she's intact.
Thank God. I want her back.
Well, Doc...
All right, then, what are you gonna say? Fair enough. Take plastic?
Not unless it's wrapped around a stack of cash.
All right, listen, maybe we can work it out today.
Oh, I don't know. I ain't been sick in 3 years, Doc. But I got an idea. Hey, where'd you learn to carve like that? You're pretty darn good with a knife.
Yo. Hey, Maddie.
Hi, Emma.
So you guys are pig sitting for me tonight?
Uh-huh. Hey, Jeff.
Whoa, who are you?
Don't tease me.
No, I'm serious. You look a little like Lou, but you're a lot prettier.
I'm warning you, Stoner could probably whoop you in a fist fight.
All right.
Be a good girl.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay,
we'll
be good girl.
We'll be late.
Not too much TV for her, okay?
Okay.
She's a real pig about that.
thanks.
Daddy's in the backyard taking his usual firestorm in the barbecue.
So you're Nick's daughter.
Gosh, I hope so. I'm in as well.
Hey, y'all, look who's here.
Oh, Lou. Oh, Stone.
Check Hollywood for knives. I don't want them operating on me later in case I sneeze or something.
Isn't this gonna be fun?
Oh, no, thank you. I'm a vegetarian.
I know, dear, but I'm still hopeful.
So am I. Vegetarian.
Oh, since when?
When you have some of this squash, Ben Stone, fresh from the earth. Don't be shy.
I'm not sure I trust a man who doesn't eat meat.
Hey, don't be so provincial. Where's your sense of adventure?
Probably give vegetarians a better rate for life insurance than a smoker, though, for example.
On account of that lower cholesterol factor.
Daddy, please, new subject. We want to hear all about California.
I heard that the women out there have their chests enlarged, their thighs vacuumed, and barf on purpose.
Not while people are eating.
Yeah, tell us about real doctoring, Stone. You know, big city medicine, huh?
Well, you know, so much has changed in the 40 years since you went to medical school, Doctor. I wouldn't really know where to start.
Smart ass.
Got you good.
More squash, Ben.
No, I mean, no. No, thank you.
Hour of the cradle, endlessly rocking. Out of the mockingbird's throat, the musical shuttle. Hour of the ninth month.
Is this one of the long ones?
No.
Long ones? Doc Hogue does a complete Walt Whitman if you don't monitor his drinking.
Down from the showered halo, up from the mystical play of shadows.
Man, I haven't seen this many stars in a long time.
I used to get so bored in this town, I'd try to count them.
I could have gone to med school. Just the science part of it I had a problem with.
I'd lie on my back, sometimes Wayne would be on top of me doing the wild thing. It was hard not to lose my place.
God, that's romantic.
Then we moved to Manhattan. Could hardly see any stars, let alone count them.
Stars I'd like to see are more of the two-legged kind.
Earthquake insurance is something I'm keen to take a whack at out there in L.A. Talk about your no-brainer. Collect premiums for a gazillion years, and if the big one ever does hit, declare bankruptcy and retire.
Decent and solid.
Nobody's perfect.
Hank, you got to take Hogue home. He's about to launch into Song of Myself.
Oh, my Lord.
Never a dull moment, eh, Ben Stone?
I'll call you later. Yes. Make sure you got home okay. I forgot my pig.
She's sleeping with them. I'll drop her off in the morning.
Greek death. Take the edge off.
Take the edge off what?
Me.
You, ran all the way over here.
Oh, yeah, I ran. Walked. Got a stitch in my side.
Why are you giving me the full court press if you're only leaving in a couple of days anyway?
You know, I don't know. It's like it's some kind of mystical force.
Force or hormones?
Hey, come on. All I want to do is talk.
Oh.
And get you sloppy drunk.
Honesty, that's a new approach.
I know. You're forcing me in uncharted territory here. might even try chastity. Seems to work for Hank.
Speak of the devil.
Well, listen, maybe a rain check?
I never should have accepted those flowers.
What about tomorrow night?
Really, desperation. I like this. Still, I wouldn't want the mayor to have to lose $10 over me, you know.
They tell me.
Hey, Mr. McClary! Be careful you don't get another hook in your finger!
Don't worry, Doc! We're not using hooks today!
House calls are probably my favorite part of the job. Just driving out into the country, seeing what might pop up around the next bend. Rainbows. Frost on the kudzu. John Muir said it. Most people are on the world, not in it, you know. What?
Nothing.
What?
Listen, you better let me handle this one alone, all right? Obstetrical exam.
Okay,
yeah.
Sure.
So Jimmy Joe went over to the Pakistani's house with a shotgun.
Excuse me. Jimmy Joe is Ellen's brother?
No, her boyfriend.
Oh, I stumped on that one, too.
And he stayed outside shooting holes in the fella's foreign car until Ellen came out and agreed to come back home with him. It's the most romantic thing Jimmy Joe's ever done for her. Tough one.
How's Ellen making out with the Pakistani man?
Get him. Come on, Bubba.
I said no shot.
Well, I don't see an infection, but... Okay, hold still. Ah. What is that, a V8?
He did it!
You know, house calls used to be an essential part of every doctor's practice. I mean, the only way you could really get to know your patients was to see where they lived, how they lived. Maybe when I get to Halverstam's, I'll get him to institute some kind of visitation program. I mean, literally outpatient.
Damn it.
Hey, Lou. Lou.
You see another one? They mark their way with these. Because they're too stupid or too drunk to remember where they were most times.
Who?
Hunters. Maybe this is the end of the... Yes, see, there it is. That's where they sit and wait for the slaughter. It's not like they do it for food either. God, it gets me so hot. You want to help me here?
What are you doing?
I'm urinating.
You just drop trout whenever you feel like.
Well, it scares the deer away so the hunters won't get them.
Why don't you just, you know, say boo or something?
I try to spread it around a little here, a little there. Feel free to join in. Anyway, it's not like I planned to be pregnant at 19, but it could have been worse than Wayne. And Wendell Barnes. Oh, you'd be interested in him. He comes from a whole family that doesn't have sweat glands.
Really? I'm fascinated by the glandless.
I guess it's genetic. During the summer, they all sleep under the house on account of the heat.
That's a touching story. Really, thanks for sharing that with me.
Well, you don't see a lot of things in Grady, but what you see a lot of.
You know, I'm from a small town myself.
What?
Marionville, Indiana. Population 2,106. Home of the world's largest steam engine.
But you've been telling everybody that you're...
No. Everybody assumed I was a big city guy. Nobody asked. Anyway, I got out and I'm staying out.
Have you still got your whole family there?
Well, they talked about leaving, but my dad never quite. They lived there, they died there. For better or for worse. So when I left home, I just swore to myself I was never going back.
It's not the place, it's the person. Be careful what you wish for, Ben Stone. You might get it.
What's that supposed to mean?
You've never been back, not even to see your friends.
Well, who's got time for friends, you know?
Lou, you gotta get Dr. Stone back here ASAP. Over. We got a possible coronary emergency.
What happened, Hope?
Can't Doc Hope handle this?
It is Hope. Over.
Hey, lie down.
No crap, I'm doomed.
Lie down now. You're having a heart attack.
My angina's acting up, Laura. You got any nitro pills out
no,
there?
No, get
in the
a
bag?
Bolus of lidocaine.
I'm the senior sawbones around here, Stone.
Your PVCs are too close to your T waves. In another 30 seconds, you're gonna be in serious trouble.
You get this weanling away from me?
Listen, if I'm wrong, the lidocaine won't hurt you, and if you're wrong, you're looking at a ventricular.
I'm
shit.
Never wrong.
Shit. All right. Curve later over here. Never wrong. 400 watts. Clear.
Clear!
Heartbeat.
Fixed it.
Wow, you mean he actually has one? All right, keep him on oxygen. Set the lidocaine drip. Guess I'm staying here tonight.
Oh, doctor. I've got your bed ready.
Right.
Sleep well, doctor.
At which point all the bees, including Melvin, lunged off the edge of the stage like lemmings, a standing ovation.
Variations on a theme. Sorry I missed it. That's the first squash pension that I missed in 15 years.
What's going on here?
It's called moral support for the recovering patient.
Cherry cobbler band.
Everybody out, let's go. Oh. Come on, visiting hours over.
Oh, don't mind Doc Hollywood. He doesn't know what it means to be beloved.
Hold on, Doc.
You come to clean the room, my bedpan's ripe.
Oh, no.
Not Maddie's sweet potato pie.
You can razz me all you want, Doc. I saved your life last night. You know it, and I know it. Gotcha. Dr. Haverston, please. It's Ben Stone calling.
He's in consultation.
Right, it's regarding... I'm not going to be able to make my interview on Friday. Well, I realize the doctor has a tight schedule. It's just that I'm not going to be able to leave without... Right, is there any way that he can reschedule the appointment for another time? All right. Thanks a lot.
What's the object of this one, pal?
10 shots, $1. 5 bullseye, win a possum.
Suppose now as you hit 5 out of 5.
If you do that, I'll give you 2 possums.
Sir, run Henry a tab. He feels deadly today.
Evening, Dr. Stowe.
Hey, Doc!
Oh, is the blue house?
The new one's in. Your chariot's good as new, or good as new used, since it's old.
You fixed my car?
Even all the ashtray.
Oh, man, I can't believe this. Melvin, thanks, man.
There's always some extra parts when I put them back together. I don't know why. But you go ahead on. Keep them.
Dance with me or I'm dog food.
What?
Wendell Barnes.
The glamorous Barnes?
Uh-huh.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Trick. Just to visualize the target on the backs of your eyeballs and then pretend you just shoot yourself in the eye.
House Hope.
Meaner never. Vance?
Where's Hank?
Not yet.
Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy. Crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me as long.
Stone, I have a present for you.
Thanks, John.
I want to thank you for saving my old friend Hoag's miserable life. And that said, I wouldn't be able to call myself a Christian if I didn't give you a full pardon on the remainder of your sentence. You're free to go whenever you want. What I wouldn't give to be a young man on the road, foot loose and fancy free. Did I tell you, I've already got plans for a new fence. Of a sudden, I got a bug in my ear for one of those solid oak numbers with curly tops.
Hey, Victor.
Did you kill that critter all by yourself, Hank?
Very funny, ha-ha. Don't you have some kind of urgent business thousands of miles away from here, Doctor?
Philula, your daughter was dumping grasshoppers in the punch bowl again.
Oh, shake a leg with the judicial branch, Miss Nevis?
Why, I'd love to.
Hold this possum, Emma. I think it's time I reacquainted your mom with some real dancing. No offense, Hollywood.
When you gonna be in your pick back now?
Been looking for you. What a great day. Boy, this is it. The pinnacle of existence, the grandeur of Grady. Sap of life. Couldn't be happier if I was twins.
You put on a hell of a festival, Mayor.
It's you nice to say so. Hey, Ben, let's talk turkey. Or squash, as it were.
About what?
Home. Heart. Happiness. You belong here, Ben Stone. Breaks my heart to think of you out there in the land of lunatics. But I'm danged if I'm gonna let you go without holding up a mirror to your face. Now, right, that smile of contentment there. Say, see that? See there? That's a face that's liked and loved. A face with friends and a future.
You find some other way to force me to stay?
Man, I'm everything but devious.
Mayor Nicholson, could you come check these ribs and tell me if they're done?
I sure can. Rigors of the job, huh?
Well, you got your fire way too high. I said you
had to. Oh, we're gonna.
closer.
I know I shouldn't be doing this because you're leaving the day after tomorrow, but I don't care. I can't help it. So get in.
Do you mean what I think you mean?
Just get in if you're gonna get in.
Lou, I gotta be honest with you. Rowing a boat is not what I had in mind.
Not bad, huh?
Incredible. What was that?
Freshwater mullet. They see the sparks from the skyrockets, think it's food, and jump for it.
Well, that's scary. Maybe I can sit next to you and you could protect me.
No, you'll throw us off balance.
I want you off balance.
The boat! Oh,
it's
no, 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 get him, get him, get him,
kill him. Tip us over, watch it, okay?
Get him, Luke.
He did that on purpose.
All right, I admit it. I worked my way through college by training bass.
Ben, I don't think I've ever wanted anything more in my entire life, ever. I'm just not used to being a one-night stand.
You don't have to be.
No, I wouldn't know what to do with myself in Los Angeles. Too many choices. Let's not think about it, okay?
Do this.
Do you mind walking from here? I don't want to give the gossips any more fat to chew.
Right.
Don't worry, Benjamin. It'll all work out.
Hey, Jasmine. Hey, Hank.
You've made me real mad.
About what?
What do you think? I know you were out on that lake with her. Makes me sick to think of you and her.
Nothing happened.
All right.
Hey, nothing happened! Come on, pussy! Come on, country boy! You want to take a shot at me? Huh? Come on!
What are you doing?
Come on, country boy! Get up! Let's go!
Are you paranoid or something?
No. And I'm a little confused.
Suppose you and her will be getting married now.
What?
It's a southern way. Man and woman as one. Make sacrifices to build equity and a future that has security.
Why do you sound like a Mutual of Omaha ad?
Fine. Joke it up. At least I was prepared to marry her.
She's not in love with you, Hank.
Okay, that's the only roadblock, though.
Let me ask you something. Don't you think a guy's entitled to choose his own destiny? You know, whether it's in a small town or even in California, just that he shouldn't have it handed to him. You know, like it's a, you know, like
a hat?
Right, okay, good. Like a hat. Your father wore it, your grandfather wore it too, and now you're stuck with it, only the damn thing is too small, you know? It just doesn't fit.
I hate a tight hat.
And there's a lot of hats out there, Hankster, and even if this one fits, and I'm not saying that it does, just hypothetically, how do you know it's the right one when you haven't even tried any others on?
I sure haven't.
I mean, that's what I'm talking about. I just don't want to screw up her life.
You know, Hollywood, sometimes a man's got to do what a man's got to do. And maybe it's in California.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
Well, I'm glad we got that cleaned up.
Me too, Hank.
Don't that take the rag off the bush? Don't forget what I told you.
I dropped by, see how you were doing.
No damn good. Water's broke. I hurt. This ain't like none of the others.
Nah, they never are. Mary, did Doc Hoke say anything to you about this baby might be coming out the wrong way?
Oh, he's coming. He don't care which way.
Fiddlesticks. Don't push, Mary.
I can run, get an ambulance.
No, there's not gonna be time for that, Kyle. Why don't you go into my duffel bag? There's four or five clean shirts, and I want you to get them and rip them into even pieces. All right. Listen. Mary, don't push, all right? I know you're gonna want to, but just don't push. I'm gonna try to turn him around so he's coming out the right way.
Is it these ones? Ermanna?
Armani. Armani, those are the ones.
Get him! Okay, now. Good. Ray. Good. Okay.
Now go, push. Push, Mary. Push, Mary. You're doing great. I got a leg. Okay, don't push. Okay, all right. Go ahead.
Someone's coming. Doc? Someone's coming.
Go ahead. Okay, all right.
Okay, one. Here we go. Push me! Great.
Doc, your car!
What do
what to do.
Okay.
Oh, let go. What do I do?
Push, man.
I think I can fix that.
Out!
You rang? First breach you ever delivered?
First baby I ever delivered. By myself.
Whiskey?
No, thanks. In fact, I wouldn't recommend that for you either.
Well, you're not my doctor and you're not my wife, so I guess you don't have very much to say about it. Oh, you're not fixing to stay, eh, Stone? Change your mind, huh? Now that your car's all busted to bupkis and you're feeling pretty good about yourself in general, huh? Yes. Come here. I added them up once. Over 700 babies I delivered in this town over the years. Nurse Packer. She popped right out, complete with teeth and hair, and bit me. An omen. Nicholson. Hank. Yeah, I gave them birth. Saw them through every sneeze and sniffle, and sometimes even walked them to the gravesite. This is pretty well my portfolio, Stone. An old car, an old house. I wouldn't trade any of them for gold.
Well, maybe gold. Or cash money.
Hey,
Doc.
Hey, Mary, how's our girl?
We decided she's gonna be Benjamina after you.
What? Thank you. There's an obstetrician coming up from Athens General later today just to make sure everything's okay. Benjamina.
Yo, Doc. I wanted to just thank you for, you know, everything. So I made you this in appreciation. I know it ain't very much, so if there's ever anything I can do for you, anything at all.
Just let me know what happens with Ellen, Jimmy Joe, and Pakistani.
I heard what happened last night. You did great.
Didn't know what the hell I was doing.
Well, sometimes that's the best way. Ben, there's something that I wanted to say.
Something I wanted to say to you first. Is that okay?
Okay.
So, I've been doing a lot of thinking about last night. I mean, last night was really difficult for me. You see, everything's all turned around now. You know, I've been thinking about you and me. Big cities, small towns, and...
Well, I'm gonna marry Hank. I've decided. It's a plane ticket to Los Angeles. The whole town chipped in. I mean, we've kept you here this long, and if you have to wait for Melvin to fix your car again... You've got Los Angeles waiting for you. I've got Emma. It's not fair to you. Hank's steady, and he's here. You're like a big, bright shooting star, and you're right, Ben. You'd burn out here.
Hey. Wait a minute.
Well, Ben Stone, you have 5 minutes to say goodbye to Shangri-La. Cotton will give you a police escort to the airport.
We made you a sack lunch.
Airplane food can cause gas.
Well, guess I'll watch after your pig. Just hope she takes to the farm after living in town like this.
Appreciate it.
A lot of folks around here gonna miss you. I don't mean me, but a lot of folks.
Back to the interstate, Ben Stone, huh? Back to the interstate.
You okay?
Oh, yes, I am fine.
Good morning, Haversham Clinic. Could you help, please? Good morning, Haversham Clinic. Good morning, Haversham Clinic. Good morning, Oh, hold. Yes, doctor. Mr. Stone?
Dr. Stone.
Oh, Dr. Haversham can see you now.
Do you have any idea how many applications I had to go through this year, Stone?
Oh, yes, sir. Hey, that's why I knew this interview was important, sir. I would have been here earlier if I could have been. I do think, though...
I know you're a great surgeon, Stone. That whole file's full of great surgeons. Did you expect some special consideration because we come from the same hometown? Because I knew your father before he died?
No, sir.
Good.
Because you didn't get shit.
Wouldn't have been here at all if it hadn't been for a call I got from Dr. Reyes Hoag.
Dr. Hoag called you?
Well, I saw two doctors last week with more experience than you and
better board certification scores. Mm-hmm.
Dr. Hoag's a piece of work, isn't he?
What did he say?
That you were doing volunteer family practice down south somewhere?
Yes. Yes, that's right.
Went there to get that small town chip off your shoulder, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, you're braver than I was, Stone. In any case, Hope said you were, quote, one
hellaciously fine position that I would be a bovine, clodpated, city-fied moron if I didn't hire you on the spot. Wrote it down so I wouldn't forget. So I guess you're in, Stone. Congrats. What time do I tee off? You do play golf, don't you?
Great. The door about that one. It's not anywhere you can see it. The secret to this business, son, is to get a good pace going for yourself. Now, nobody likes to admit it, but medicine's a volume business. 99% of what we do is boilerplate surgery. But it means we can afford the 1% that's meaningful. Disfigurements, birth defects, hairless, cleft palates. You live for those moments.
Of course, the bigger you get, the bigger the nut. We're a service industry. Comes with the territory. Fixed cost, specialization. People adjust to it or fail. Cable TV, you're going to see some changes, Stone. Stone, let's see if patient number 434 is in pre-op yet. We can squeeze one more in before lunch, don't you think?
The V2 bomber is Pepsi to the Soviet Union. In the way.
Excuse me?
Some girl called for you. Said you'd know who it was. Said she'd meet you at this bar. Like, as if you're gonna rush right over there. Right. Totally unbelievable Southern accent. An actress, I'll bet. Yeah, hi. I'm supposed to meet someone, a girl.
Ben!
Coming.
Nancy Lee.
Well, I had to give it a shot, you know? I mean, I just thought, just in case.
South of Venice.
Guess not.
You drove all this way just to bring me my car?
Sort of. Well, I mean, you know, gave me an excuse to get the hell out of Grady. Pardon my French. I mean, things were bad before, but since he left, they got positively stagnant.
How's Hogg?
Well, he's the same.
Melvin?
Same.
How's your dad?
Why don't you ask me about Vailula?
No, I mean, what's there to ask, really? I mean, I guess so. I used, you know, she and Hank are.
You're in my chair. Slide a bit, Nancy Lee. There's a man in the toilet selling aftershave. Now, what's that all about?
Hank. What are you doing here?
Took my own advice, Doc. Knowing when to stay, when to get out.
Yeah, I thought you and Lou were gonna get.
Oh, Lou was never gonna marry me, so I broke it off clean.
You dumped her?
Man's got to do what a man's got to do, even if it's in California. Sense of higher purpose, you know?
Is that a star?
No, that's Ted Danson.
I'm going for breakfast. You want anything?
Mm-hmm. How about Bob Barker?
I'll see what I can do.
Howdy.
You steal that pig?
Well, I heard she was wasting away in this one pig town.
So and you thought you'd come back and rescue her.
Yeah. Something like that.
What makes you think she'll take you back?
Because I love her.
Go back to Los Angeles.
I don't want Los Angeles. I want you.
You got great tonsils.
That ain't all. You know, I just thought of something. I guess I'm gonna have time to collect that $10 from Nick.
You lost that bet.
I did not. Who says
it? Says me.
Says you. You have no say in this bet. You are the bet.
I don't care. The bet was for 1 week. You lost.
Ah, it's your word against mine.
You mean you would sully my reputation?